this time on my 4x4, we're heading down the inland track. We've had a huge amount of rain through here the past couple of days, so we're going to go and explore the inland track for something different, and hopefully the Hilux will get a little bit wet. So, if you'd like to tag along for the ride, I'll show you what Canunda National Park's like in winter. I'm going to let the tyres down for about 8, and we'll go from there. Let's go.
Come onto the beach for the first time. The tide is certainly very high, and apparently this is actually low tide, so I hate to see it when it gets a little bit higher. Don't have much room between the car and the bank. In some places the tides actually wash right up on the inland track. We'll keep chugging along. So far we haven't found any water on the inland track, so we'll take the beach for a little while. If you can. Looks quite sketchy. You can always turn around, I suppose. And this is supposed to be the hardest part of the beach. Not today. We're not getting through there today. Alright, so we have actually reached number 2. We come all the way through from Carpenter's Rocks by the inland track, and there's just no water. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Maybe a couple of puddles, but you know, just enough to wet the wheels or the treads. It's like nothing. So very disappointing. Very. And that was like a huge shower of rain we had yesterday. But we're, as I said, we've made it to number 2, and the bay is probably the worst I've seen it in a very long time, as that clip I just shown you. And yeah, I don't know how we're going to go along the rest of the beach, but I think it might be inland track the rest of the way. Other than that, Hilux is doing very well, and everybody's happy. So we'll keep plugging along, see how far we can get. That tide didn't look very good, so yeah, oh, very good. We'll get there. If you can tell by the sand, the tide has actually been right up there on the inland track. We're the first ones through here since the wet. Which is quite exciting. But we're not going through there today. No way. Can't get through. mirror. Somewhere there. No damage, which is good. One bonus is having a ute, I suppose. Okay, let's try this again, shall we? So we come onto the beach about Little Rock, and we'll just decide to go for a bit of a drive along the coast here, see how far we can get before we have to go inland again. Big washout back there, there's no way you can get through it, so we bypass that and come back out the beach. It certainly makes it interesting, winter time. The beach is a lot more fun, a lot more challenging, but you do have to be careful. You end up getting yourself bogged real quick. That's alright. What if you're on third? Too much for it in third gear. Wait a second. Sitting on just over 2,000 revs, hardly working. This is in a place you do not want to be. I'm right in the middle of washout, waves are coming in, and I've had to resort to low range. Come on, Luxie, you can do it. Open diffs, no lockers. Absolutely sacks full of salt water. I can't drive with that in there. Watch, see, on the bus. Spraying salt water. I'm gonna have to get a new air filter and clean this and dry this one out with petrol or something. This is ridiculous, but I'm gonna have to drive out of here with no air filter. That's sad. Can't do that to a poor dude. Managed to get out of there, only just. what happened is we drove up beside the sandbank and the rear brakes locked on, the handbrakes. So had a bit of a trouble there trying to get over the sand hill. But we're currently driving on the road with no air cleaner. It's full of water. But yeah, the Hilux seems to be running okay. It did die on us there for a little while, but it sounds like it's running okay, so hopefully there's no valve damage or anything like that. But as far as everything goes, I've got a bit of a dent in the door from them when that wave hit. Huge wave come over, just rocked the bus, so I jumped in the tray. Don't want to do that again. But yeah, my steering wheel's cock-eyed. You can see that. So, yeah, other than that, I'm still doing pretty well. I'll go home and give her a grease up, give her a tune up, wash, make sure everything's all hunky-dory, and bang that dent in the door out. Should be all good, hopefully. So remember, don't take any risks. That was a real stupid move by me. The tide was high, it's getting higher. Well, I was aware of that, but just got the better of me. I thought the beach was reasonably good, but through that washout, it was just absolutely horrible. Just goes to show how you can get caught out. But anyway, I'll stop talking, let you guys get on with your day, and I hope you enjoyed the video. So stay tuned for more on Water 4x4. I really hope you enjoyed the video, because I've nearly had a heart attack. So, alright. Too easy, guys. Have a good one. Why is it that I can hear a whistle? Sounds like a turbo.